Hello dear student, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to take the concern of or I'm going to talk about the very important topic that begins the grammar of English, the part of speech. Generally there are 8 part of speeches or the part of speech. For example, noun, pronoun, verb, adverb, adjective, preposition, conjunction and interjection. The part of speeches or the part of speech indicates how the word functions in meaning as well as grammatically within the sentence. An individual word can function as more than one part of speech when used in different circumstances, right? So today, my dear student, I'm going to start the presentation on noun. So what is noun, right? So noun is present every sentence or in every writing or everywhere you can find the noun. Okay, so let us understand what is noun. In very simple words, I can tell you that a part of speech or the noun that denotes a person, okay, or not only a person, to a place, thing or animal or idea. Okay, so when we talk about noun, the simple thing we must understand that it refers to a person, item, things or place. Okay, so for example, I can tell you the prime minister, okay, my sister, a boy, Barack Obama, these are the names of a person, names of a places, Australia, my kitchen, Mount Everest, the beach, okay, things, an idea, the dog, my plate, the movie. These are the various examples of various nouns. So let us try to understand the different types of noun. So in this presentation, I'm going to talk about the very important things, that is concrete noun, common noun and proper noun, abstract noun, countable and uncountable nouns, collective nouns, compound nouns, possessive nouns, regular and plural noun, okay, regular plural nouns or irregular plural nouns. Okay, so let us see one by one. So today when we talk about the concrete noun are those that we can easily observe with the help of our 5 senses. Okay, so here you can touch, you can sight, you can hear, you can listen, right? So with these, with your 5 senses, 5 organs, you can easily understand the concrete nouns. It means you can touch, for example, dog. I can touch to dog, I can see that dog, right? Means practically or physically it is present in my in my surroundings or in my house. Okay, so the things that you can touch with your organs or your senses, for example, knife, house, giraffe, ocean, notebook, pen. Okay, so all these examples comes under concrete noun. And another category is common noun or proper noun. So common noun are always capitalized, you must remember. Common noun are always not capitalized in any sentences. For example, I like my mother. So I cannot capitalize the word mother because mother is a common noun. Father, sister, brother, boy, girl, these words I can write with the small alphabets or in lowercase you can say. But in the case of, or on the other hand, proper nouns are always written in, or many times written in capitalize, or it begins with the capital word. For example, Canada, New Zealand, Marvel, Superman, right? So these are the names of a particular place, person, or thing you can say. Okay, now come to the abstract noun. So abstract noun are those that actually, this is absolutely or obvious exact opposite to the concrete noun. And these refers to the ideas, qualities, feelings that are not tangible. Okay, for example, love, anger, hate, beauty, honesty, bravery, faith, truth, liberty. So these are the various abstract noun, you can say. So the abstract nouns or the class of this noun is the opposite to concrete noun. We can't experience these nouns with our senses. And if a noun is abstract, it describes something you can't see, hear, touch, smell, or taste. Okay. For example, love. I love my husband. So love is always abstract. It is not visible to your senses, right? You can experience, but you cannot see, you cannot taste, you cannot hear. Okay. Come to the next one. Okay. Then the countable and the uncountable nouns. There are some nouns that we can count or some are uncountable. Okay. So countable nouns, it means we can count the nouns. For example, if there is one apple, two apple, three apple, five apple, likewise you can say one dog, two dog, three dogs. Okay. So if I say there is a man at the door, so I can use an article that is a or an in this case. For example, an apple. I have an apple. I have a dog. Okay. I don't have a dog. Right? On the other hand, the uncountable nouns, you can say, usually operate with a single verb. How? Let us see. For example, you can say, I want bread. I'm going to buy rice. Let's enjoy coffee. Okay. I'm going to give you information about computer. I cannot say informations. I cannot write in furnitures. Okay. I cannot say luggages, advices, monies. You cannot write like in by using these another suffixes. Okay. So for example, when we talk about the tea, water, fear, coffee, anger, happiness, or ideas, you must use these words, or that will come under the uncountable noun. Then we can try to understand the compound noun. So what is compound noun? Compound noun is a noun that is made with two or more words. This is very easy. And a compound noun is usually, it's a combination of two nouns, or it's a combination of adjective or noun, noun or adjective, verb plus noun, noun plus verb, verb plus preposition, noun plus prepositional phrase, preposition plus noun. So it's a combination of two words. How? Let us see the example. When two nouns come together like bus stop, is this the bus stop for the number 12 bus? I can say. So this is football. Okay. I love football. So two nouns come together and it becomes a separate noun. So this is known as a compound noun. So when I use the adjective and noun, for example, whiteboard, blackboard. Okay. Verb and noun, dining table. Noun plus verb, sunrise or sunset. Okay. Verb plus preposition, check out. Okay. So these are the various words that I can use or that I can bring under this category. For example, when I say noun plus prepositional phrase, okay, brother-in-law, mother-in-law, sister-in-law, father-in-law, these words comes under compound words. Okay. Then another important word or noun is possessive noun. What is possessive noun? When we show our ownership in any cases, or when we show that this thing or this place or this person belong to me, that time possessive noun works. Okay. So possessive nouns usually form an adding an apostrophe s to the end of a noun, right? So now this is very important for you because most of the times people, for example, you and me also, we always make mistake while writing this noun. Okay, when you can see dog's house, right? For example, if I say puppy's collar or Joe's car, Jem's book. Okay, Jem's book will be published next month. What will happen here? In this word, I have used the sign apostrophe after the word book, and after that I have written yes, James book. Okay, birds, chicks. You can see on the screen singular and plural. So there is a difference in between the singular possessive noun and the plural possessive noun. Okay, I cannot write plural nouns like this. I have to write boys. So that apostrophe sign will come at the end of that noun. Boys, tables, girls. Okay. Then regular plural noun. This is again, these things I must discuss with you. A regular plural noun that always, you know, comes with the suffixes yes or es. For example, cat, cats. Okay, dog, dogs. Fox, foxes. Girls. Okay. Then irregular plural noun. This is quite interesting to learn here. There are some irregular plural nouns that are not formed by using suffixes yes or es, because most of the times the total word has been changed when we use the plural nouns. For example, wife, wives, life, lives, leaf, leaves. Okay, so the noun that ends with the letter F or FE, you must change that word into wives, lives, leaves. Okay, so again, the noun ends with the vowel O, like potato or hero. So it becomes potatoes, heroes. Novel changing the vowels. For example, the plural of tooth is teeth. The plural of woman is woman. Okay. There are some other important things, that large spelling changes or no change plural. Vortex, vortices, index, index, or mice, mouse, mice, ox, oxen. Okay. So this is quite interesting to learn about noun today. I hope, my dear student, you understood or you enjoy this. Thanks for watching. If you are new to my channel, you can subscribe my channel for upcoming videos. Thank you.